Alright, good afternoon. Hello. Welcome back to another day of USC 2023 action. We continue onward in the round of 32 with Florida versus Kentucky. Florida, of course, the only state that isn't a California to have won a USC 2 years ago. Beginning their campaign to reclaim that throne, which they achieved. And we're back on Coconut Mall, but it's a different time signature now. But it is a somewhat new look Florida team. And by that I mean it's exactly the same Florida team. But it was a new look from when they won. XRK's Ludo Cappy, Almighty Door, Ramton, or Axie. A lot of pretty familiar faces there to people who have been watching USC over the past couple of years. And on the other side, of course, it is Team Kentucky, who might be making their debut in USC, but I'm not positive, so somebody can fact-check me on that one if they would like. Kentucky's a bunch of people actually, they probably played last year, I think, because I think I already had a flag for them, so they probably played before. Anyway. Captain by Joy, team has Castellan, Gage, Rowe, Zeno, ESQ, and Cash, which is kind of a sick username to have. I'm surprised that somebody was able to get that, actually. I wonder when he joined the game. How long he's been called? 2018 account, and they're called Cash. That's kind of sick. tourney client is not broken. They just literally have one person playing. So we're absolutely chilling currently at the moment right now. But yeah, this is, I think, going to probably be another somewhat one-sided affair in all likelihood. Florida is really, really good in early rounds. They could have won last year if a certain player did not exist, because that one player just out-skill-capped literally everyone else in the tournament. But barring that, I mean, they could have repeated last year. As champions, they would have gone back-to-back 2021-2022. But now I think they're back again with a really good chance at winning this year, because they just have a solid depth of roster. They've got a lot of experience, several players who are very, very good, regardless of how much they may have been playing in tournaments. You can't argue with the experience on that roster. So this is just kind of step one, I think, for Florida trying to reclaim their spot at the top of the podium. Obviously, multiple very strong teams this year, but I think the overall skill cap of this tournament has kind of dropped this year, with maybe the exception of Rektigan. You're missing out on some of the historic, really best players we've seen in this tournament. Like, the last couple years, we've seen Utami. You know, we saw, obviously, Vaxe and Idki a couple years before that. If you go back far enough, you get to the era of, Toy and Fiery Rage carrying NorCal. So a lot of those players are not around anymore, and there are still really strong players, but I think the absolute tip-top skill cap may have dropped off a bit, which I think opens the door a little bit for teams that are really, really well-rounded and have a high skill floor, but maybe a slightly lower skill ceiling. So we are going to get into, well, we're going to get through the bans very quickly. It's a DT2 ban from Kentucky and a Nomad 1 ban from Florida, which makes me sad because I like Nine Lie a lot, but oh well. One of the rare times you'll hear T1G saying that he likes a Nomad 1, because it's not really a Nomad 1. And Florida gonna, or excuse me, Kentucky gonna open up proceedings with Hidden 2. That's bold. I don't know that I saw that coming. This is a team, Kentucky is, unfortunately for me, a team that I'm just not that familiar with the players from as far as skill sets go. But it seems kind of terror to pick an early round Hidden 2 into Exarch Digital Hypno. Especially when, like, this map is very straightforward and not all that reading heavy. And in we are going to go. So we've got XR Cappy, Digital Hypno for Florida, Castellan, Xeno, and Gage Rowe for Kentucky. Opening up with Kentucky's first pick here, on the upset hunt, because this is obviously a very Florida-favored matchup, as just the vastly higher-seeded team and the team with a lot more big tournament experience. A lot of badges on that team, obviously. A lot of tournament history. But it's an early pool, so, a couple misses here and there from Florida, Kentucky could take advantage of. And that's why we play the matches, We ain't talking about practice. There is an early break from Gage Rowe, however, falling right after the spinner. Also, he maybe get a hit zone. Oh, this just has really quiet hit zones. Okay, all good. And into the first Ki we will go. Florida holding a triple FC versus a 2 FC lead. the accuracy for Gaudreau, not what you'd like it to be, nor for Castellan down at 95%. And there goes Zeno, who was holding the best ACK on their team, but did unfortunately break. And about a quarter of the way through, Florida's going to start to pull into a pretty sizable lead, because that is now 3 FCs to 1, and that 1 FC is at 96 ACK versus all 99s for Florida. You know, I'm not saying that there was ever, like, there's ever, like, a concern that Florida could lose this match, but I think it definitely looks good for them if they come out and really, like, go just all gas, no brakes mode on this match and just show people that they're here to play this year. Because it feels like some of the pre-tournament conversation has kind of circled around, you know, Virginia with Rectigon, obviously. You know, Texas having a strong roster again, the California teams looking, you know, new look but still strong. And you can never let Florida get kind of lost in, you know, the shadow of any of these other teams, because they've historically been one of the most consistently high-performing teams in this tournament. There was a break from Digital Hypno, but it doesn't really matter. It's matched a little bit later by Castellan. Gaudreau breaking once again as well. This is going to be a very, very scarily one-sided affair by the time all is said and done. Though there is another break for Cappy, so it's going to mitigate just how bad this could have been. But they are still up by 600k nonetheless. Head into the last Ki, last quarter of the map. Lone FC remaining in the lobby is on Exarch. Very high accuracy on Cappy and Digital Hypno. This could have been a really disgusting scoreline if those two hadn't broken, but it's going to be a million or so plus points regardless. So, obviously Florida never in any sort of danger in this map. And it's going to be a quick break point to start things off here. Just what the doctor ordered if you are a Florida player or fan. Get your 2023 USC campaign off right with a 1.1 million point win on map number one. They take the break point on Hidden 2. They will head into their own pick with about as much comfort and confidence as you could possibly ask for. And that is going to be a very speedy Hard Rock 2 pick. Also, Zeno had 1-100 and 4 misses. What a weird lobby. 1-100, 4 misses on Zeno. 3-100 is FC on Exarch. 1-100, 250s on Cappy. So that's one or two slider breaks for him. 2-100 is 150 for Digital Hypno. That's bizarre. I don't know what we just witnessed. Anyway, Hard Rock 2 next map is going to be Chirality. Yao Jing Yao's insane. Somewhat streamy, small circle size, Hard Rock pick. Got some bursts, a little bit of aim, some sliders as well. And tends to be an arena where high seeds will almost always outperform low seeds. Hard Rock, and especially small circles, is just not... Small circles are just not something that people specialize in. You know, if you're an experienced tournament player who's done this a lot, you've obviously seen a 6.5 in every tournament you've ever played, in every pool you've ever played. But if you lack that experience, you are just not going to have played nearly as many of those maps in all likelihood. And it is going to be, I think, a little bit more of a struggle for you. So we have Araxi coming in to replace Cappy, Exarch, and Digital Hypno retaining their posts. Castellan, Cash, and Gaudreau in for Kentucky here. And in we go, map number two. See if Florida can quickly race out to a consolidated breakpoint 2-0 lead, which I have to think they will probably be capable of doing. But that is an odd couple of early breaks. Digital Hypno in like the first couple notes, Araxi following up on that stream. Not what you like to see. 91% ACK for Araxi. It's like they just weren't ready for the map to start or something. I'm not sure. Cash had an early break as well. There go Castellan and Araxi trading again. I'm really not sure what's going on here. I don't expect players to have been having as much trouble with the first 200 combo with this map as they have. But Castellan and Cash both break, and Gaudreau the only one left out at 95 ACK. Meanwhile, Exarch cool, calm, and collected. Not really, though, as she breaks as well as Gage Row. It's Digital Hypno now with the only combo. Why is everyone inting this map? What is going on, man? This is like bizarro world behavior from all of the players in this lobby. I did not expect anyone to have as much trouble with this as they're having. Especially not the Florida players. Luckily, Digital Hypno is chillin'. Can anybody confirm or deny if he's still using the Whale Cursor? Because I feel like Whale Cursor for 6.5 sounds really, really doomed. Stop. And into the back third of the map we go. Araxi to break, as well as Gage Row. Castellan and Cash following up, and now it is XR Digital Hypno going to bring this one on home. It's going to be a comfortable win for Florida. But honestly, like, this is like an underperformance from Florida on this map, to be honest. I don't know. You really expect better from them on this pick. It's the first week and they're dropping like a 250k. I don't know. Nobody, no FCs, no 800ks. Like, I mean, obviously it gets the job done and there's no pictures on the scorecard, but not the kind of score you'd expect from Florida on that map. Doesn't end up mattering, as they win comfortably by almost a million points anyway. Which, I guess, makes it sound like I'm hard-flaming Kentucky, but again, 6.5 for lower-seeded teams, pretty much always going to be a struggle, and proven that that was correct here. Alright, we are going to go to the Fremod pool. Fremod 3 picked by Kentucky, so switching up quite a bit. They go hidden to Fremod 3. This one, Streamy Fremod. Pretty straightforward map. Not too hard. A little more basic mechanics tapping focus than most of the maps in this pool that are... Well, there's really not much mechanics in this pool in general. This is kind of the outlier in that regard. So maybe Kentucky thinking on something a little more straightforward, they'll have a better time than they did on the low AR or on Florida's small circles pick. You know, we've kind of gotten the two, we've gotten the two like normally niche picks out of the way early in this one. We're gonna head to mechanics afterward. I'm expecting to see probably 1HD, 1HD HR, maybe. I don't know, like Exarch hidden Hardark and then Cappy Ranton hidden. Not sure for Kentucky. Exclamation mark bracket in chat. Or I think you can also do exclamation mark challenge. I think that works too. Holy crap, it's a bracket. Wowie. Now people are trying it and it won't work. Yeah, it could be Exarch hidden only. Nope, Exarch hidden Hardark, Cappy hidden. Haha! Get owned. Get owned, Will Stetson. You don't know shit. This is why you weren't at Roundtable. I mean, what? Castellan hidden only. Hard Rock's on both ESQ and on Gage Row. Ramton is not... Okay, Ramton has Hard Rock on. Ramton has Hard Rock on, so we're going to panic that real quick. You can always tell when that happens. So Will is slightly less wrong than he was before. It's early breaks from Ramton and Esq. And a break from Castellan. It's Gage Row and ESQ holding. So maybe, wait, did I get banjoed? I guess I got banjoed. 87 ACK on ESQ. Not having a good time at all with the accuracy. Ramton, Cappy both holding high accuracy, as is Exarch a little lower, but still doing okay for himself. I don't know if double HR was the wave. I feel like ESQ could have just gone Nomad. Does not seem to be comfortable at all with the Hard Rock. And they don't seem to have somebody who's like super comfortable on Hidden either. That's a break. It's traded between Cappy and Gage Row. But 500k lead for Florida. Exarch and Ramton holding on to the full combos. And... we're going to come down to the last third with no combo at all in Kentucky. Oh, ESQ has some combo, pardon me. But Exarch and Ramton still holding the double FC. Kind of what you expect. Florida is a team that is very good at basically everything, and that does include tapping mechanics. Exarch, of course, a really strong stream player. Rampton and Cappy likewise. Cappy maybe not at quite as at home on hidden only streams, but doing pretty well other than the break, so I guess he's going to be fine. And Rampton with the late miss. Low ACK FC, low combo FC. And that's going to be another huge win for Florida. 1.4 million points in their favor with the FC on Exarch with Hidden Hard Rock. And Rampton with the 800k plus with Hard Rock only. I got to think ESQ should have just gone Noma. They already had somebody on Hidden and somebody on Hard Rock. And that Hard Rock did not go well for him. Not really sure about that decision, quite honestly. Obviously, they know their practice scores and we don't. But I don't know that I necessarily endorse what we just witnessed. But neither Hard Rock player having a great time for Kentucky. Again, Hard Rock for lower-seeded teams continues to be a bit of a bugaboo. Just historically kind of the case. Meanwhile, Florida going to go back to the hidden pool. They're playing this one quick. So over to Hidden One, Acid Burst. Hey, guys. Hidden teams. Stream teams. We've got Bursty Hidden Tech. And Florida looking to go up a quick 4-0. Simple difference in skill, I suppose, unfortunately. So Vexart, Cappy, Araxi, Castellan, Zeno, and Gage Rowe. Will we get an Almighty Door sighting today? It feels like we may not need to get an Almighty Door sighting today. And away we go. Kentucky still looking to get on the board, and maybe the early break from Araxi could be what they needed, but there's a miss from Castellan, followed up by Exarch. Neither of these teams feels like they're really at 100% today. Evidently, at least one player missing from Kentucky, and Florida just suffering some, I don't know, kind of strange misses by their standards. There's another miss from Araxi. It's traded with another miss from Castellan. Zeno follows up next, missing on an entire burst as Castellan does the same. Exarch and Cappy going to be poised to run away with this one for Florida if Gagero finds a miss, though he is holding with very decent accuracy relative to the rest of the lobby as well. There is the miss, though, and now goodbye, Kentucky. It was nice knowing you on this pick. There goes Exarch. Okay, maybe not quite yet. Castellan and Gagero both break, though, and it is now Cappy. Cappy off to the races. 99.2 ACK. He is Voolin. I also feel like this is kind of laggy. The game is kind of laggy for some reason. Sorry for that if it's noticeable on stream. It's gonna be another break from Zeno. Meanwhile, Cappy are actually still holding on. Exarch a little farther behind. Castellan and Gagero building back up, but it's a 300k lead, so I don't know how much that's gonna matter. We still have a third of the map, though. Decent amount of score left, you can see. I mean, with Cappy still showing, what, 500k score left. A slider miss from Castellan, not gonna help matters out for Kentucky as Zeno breaks in the slow part as well before we get into the difficult diff spike at the ending. But it's a full reset for Kentucky, and any hopes they may have had on a comeback on this map are dashed. Florida time. Gonna end up being a million point win once again. It really didn't feel like it should have happened this way, but it did anyway. As Kentucky just fully struggling with this ending. And that's gonna be a job well done by Team Florida. They're gonna take their second pick. They're gonna take the 4-0 lead. Double break points consolidated. Match points in their back pocket. Cappy on a 99.3 ACK full combo. Well done, Cappy. 1.5 million points, the final margin of victory there. It was close until it wasn't, is how that one went. 1,800,000, 600,000, and the lowest score on Florida was 320,000 points higher than the highest score on Kentucky. In case you were wondering, there is a gap between the top teams and the bottom teams in this tournament. You know, we were thinking about is the gap closing? You know, the top teams have gotten, have maybe dropped off a little bit in terms of skill cap, but unfortunately, the bottom team's skill floor, I think, has also dropped because, you know, I like, obviously, as I said, Kentucky, not a new team this year, but it's just kind of a general trend that the more teams that get rosters also means the more teams that are not super great at the bottom end because they're just putting together whoever they can to get a roster. And once again, we get the banger DT1, a little more Weezer, some slightly awkward rhythm feeling in this map, and obviously, you know, a decent amount of aim. Slowdown that makes Ack a social construct. And Kentucky here with their last chance to get on the board. Down 4-0. Match points to Florida. Rampton, Cappy, Raxi, Exarch dropping out for the first time. Castellan, Zeno, and Cash looking to see if they can put up a point and avoid the sweep, which would be... I'm not actually sure. We've had several this weekend. I'm not sure what number sweep this would be, but it would probably be like the fourth. No, it would be more than that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It would be the seventh. Oh my god, this would be the seventh sweep in like 9 matches. Jeez. I didn't realize it was quite that dire. We have an early break from Rampton, but it's matched by an early break from Cash. I feel that Rampton's issue has kind of been just the random misses on maps that you would consider his maps. It happened a lot last year as well. They typically manage to get away with it just by outskilling their opponents overall. But, you know, if you get into even more even matchups, those shit misses are really going to be damaging to your chances. So he's going to have to get that under control. Fortunately here, it doesn't look like it's going to matter. With Cash and Castellan as well as Zeno all breaking, but it is something to kind of keep an eye on. Obviously, Rampton a very skilled mechanics player, but that is seemingly the concern. Obviously, it was right at the beginning. Doesn't really make a big deal difference, but you know, yeah. I need something to talk about here, guys. Pretty solid recovered combo for Cash. Unfortunately, Castellan and Zeno a bit behind the mark. And Araxi and Cappy both still holding the FCs. It's 300k lead for Florida. It's going to continue to grow if they're, especially if there are any more breaks from Kentucky, like that one from Zeno and that one from Castellan. Okay, they broke on like almost the same note. And yeah, this is pretty much done. Like stick a fork in them. It's over. The fat lady is singing. There's another break from Rampton. The only one to miss on the slowdown completely falls apart. But yeah, it's a 500k lead, so it really just doesn't matter. And we just await the speed back up and the ending. Cash on a solid combo. He's at 590. Fortunately, Castellan and Zeno are not. And Araxi and Cappy are both holding. Full combos. This is not an ACK map, by the way, hence the highest in the lobby being 96%. But job done is job done if you're Florida. Not their absolute best day, but they didn't need to have their best day, so it's all good at the end of the match. It's going to be a 5-0 sweep regardless. I can talk all I want about whether or not they played up to their potential, which they very definitely didn't. But they still won, and they still won easily. This is never a match in doubt. But if you're another team, you might be looking at some of these scores and thinking, okay, one of two things happened here. Either they're not as good as we think they are, or they just aren't practicing for early rounds because they don't feel like they need to, and they obviously didn't need to, which is probably the more likely answer to that particular question. But it is going to be a 5-0 final score. Florida heads on into the round of 16. Don't know if they have an opponent yet. We can go find that out shortly here. It's going to be Florida. They do indeed. It is going to be Florida versus Florida versus Oregon, excuse me, in the round of 16. So that's another round of 16 match solidified. And that also means that Kentucky will be facing off against Ohio down in the loser's bracket round one next week. So we'll be waiting on those and seeing how those go. But that's going to do it for now. Congratulations to Florida. Very quick 5-0 sweep for them over Kentucky, who were just never in this one. But maybe a better chance in the loser's bracket with a slightly easier opposition awaits them next week. And that'll do it. Thank you guys for watching this quick one. We are going to take the stream offline because we've got a full half hour until the next match. So it is going to be 5 p.m. Eastern, 21 UTC, Pennsylvania versus Illinois, right back here. So hopefully you stick around and we see you then on the other side of this break. But for now, congratulations to Florida. See them next week, as well as Kentucky down in the loser's bracket. And we will see you guys in 30 minutes. Goodbye.